everybody. Hooded Cobra Commander 788 here, and I was very happy to get the care package from Jaren, the one I opened last week. There were some great things in there. It's going to take a while for me to get to full reviews of them, but I didn't want to make you wait that long, especially on this one. I wanted to take a closer look at the G.I. Joe Sky Patrol Sky Havoc from 1990. It is a reissue of the 1986 Havoc, but instead of being green, it is vac metalized chrome. It is reflective, and it just looks gorgeous. Just take a look at that shiny chrome all the way around. This just looks great. This is a vehicle that I had been wanting to get for some time, and I really have to thank Jaren for sending one. Besides just the chrome, it also has some green and this brown color. This brown color, I think, is actually better than the orange color on the original Havoc. It has all the same features as the original Havoc, so you have a couple smaller guns up here in front that can turn. Then you have these two big cannons up here on top and this operator's seat. And this can swing forward. You have a clear canopy that can pop up. And of course you have a two-person cockpit there. These treads have armor plating which can be removed both in the front and in the back. And then here in the back you have a couple rear-facing missiles that peg on. You also have a couple rear-facing pivoting guns. One of them is missing on this example. Then you have the only thing that qualifies this as a Sky Patrol vehicle. If you open up the back here, it does have a sub-vehicle, this sort of flying car thing. So this does fly, so sure, it'll qualify as a Sky Patrol vehicle now. Don't forget the removable engine cover, just the same as the Havoc. This vehicle is mostly complete. It is missing a few parts. It's missing one of the missiles, and of course it's missing that top gun. Then on the Sky Car, it is missing the two mounted guns for the sides. Just for a quick comparison, here's the Sky Havoc next to the original Havoc. The original Havoc came with a driver cross country. The Sky Havoc did not come with an action figure. Now, I prefer the realistic military vehicles for G.I. Joe, and the Havoc was not realistic, but at least it was green, so it had that going for it. And as much as I liked the original green, I have to admit, sometimes I can be distracted by shiny things, and I just love the Sky Havoc. I do look forward to eventually doing a full review on it when I get it complete, but that's just a quick look at it for now. If you have not seen FormBX257's recent videos on Sky Patrol, I strongly suggest you watch them. They are fantastic. For now, this is just a quick look at the Sky Patrol Sky Havoc. Thank you again, Jaren, for sending it, and thank you for watching. I have a full vintage G.I. Joe toy review coming up this weekend, and right now there is a vote going on to decide what will be the last review of the year. So please check out my Patreon to vote. Thank you all very much for watching, and I will see you next time.